It's Heather, and I'm back with another video. This video is going to be talking about Celebrate Bisexuality Day. I put together a video of different bisexual characters from different webcomics since I thought it was appropriate, since I'm also a webcomic artist myself. So the first character I picked was Jamie from Girls with Slingshots, and she's one of the two main characters from the comic. Girls with Slingshots was created by Daniel Corsetto in 2004, and it went on till 2014, and it had a complete ending, and I believe it's still available completely for free on her website, girlswithslingshots.com, but I think you should be able to also buy her book. I do have the entire omnibus, and I had her sign it last year, and it was pretty amazing. But I picked Jamie because I think she's just a fun, cool character, and she's very confident about herself. And she's very open with everyone, and she's very, like, she loves her friends, and she loves cats, and she's just, like, all-around pretty awesome character. One of the things I like about Girls with Slingshots is that the character designs do kind of change over time. Like, for example, Jamie's hair, will change her haircut every once in a while. I went with, like, the typical default hairstyle with the little pigtails. But you can see her with, like, shorter hair, like, throughout the comic and, like, different kinds of styles and stuff. I just think it's kind of cool that she'd spend a little extra time making some extra designs to her characters. But yeah, definitely read Girls with Slingshots. It's not a completely all-ages comic. There is, like, language and stuff, and there's some references to some more adult themes. But I'd say it's probably, like, a PG-13, but it's probably okay to read most jobs if you are available to do that, unlike some of the other comics I'm going to be talking about, which definitely won't be able you wouldn't be able to read at work. All right, on to the next character. The next character I chose was Lillian from the comic Go Get a Roomie. Go Get a Roomie was started in 2010 by the artist Clove, and they're going to be ending it in 2020, I believe. It's all completely available for free online. Like, I think all of these are available right now. But you can also read their books. I know I've backed a couple of their Kickstarters. So I picked Lillian because even though she's one of the main characters, she isn't, like, outright open with her sexuality, with her life, at first anyway. She does open up later on during the comic. I don't want to spoil anything if you haven't read it. But she does eventually realize that she is attracted to multiple genders, at least. And I think she's very sweet. She sleeps all the time as her main character. The other main character, Rumi, is very, like, upbeat and very, like, open and very, like, in-your-face kind of thing. And Lillian is definitely a lot more laid back and does not, like, get into people's business, and she kind of just does her own thing, and then Rumi kind of just butts into her life. They very make a good team because they're kind of opposites, and, you know, they work very well. They balance each other out very well. But it's a comic about, like, all kinds of different, like, lifestyles and sexualities, and I think that's really cool because you can, like, learn about things you don't know. And yeah, you should definitely read it if you haven't read it. It is there is a lot of nudity in it, usually non-sexual nudity, like, because Rumi does kind of run around naked a lot. But I wouldn't suggest reading it in front of your boss or anything, for example. But definitely suggest reading it. It is an incredible story. It's very intriguing. It's been going on for, like, it'll be going on 10 years next year. And I'm sad to see it's gonna be ending, but, you know, all good things. All right, on to the next one. So the next character I picked was Z from the comic Menage a Three, and it's created by Giselle Lagasse and Dave Lumsden. And it was started in 2008 and it ended this year in 2018. I have not been able to read the entire comic yet. I'm waiting on the book right now currently. You can still read it all online for free, but I've backed the Kickstarter for every single book so far, so I have everyone but the last one at the moment. But it's actually one of my favorite webcomics. When it came out, I started reading it right away. They call it, like, an HBO style, like, comedy, I believe, so it's pretty R-rated, definitely. There is a lot of sex in it. There's a lot. Definitely can't read it at work. It's very, like, a romance comedy kind of thing. It's very slice of life. There's a lot of, like, romantic plots and different, like, things going on in their lives, and, but it's always, like, sticks to being a comedy. So there are three main characters in Menage a Three: Gary, Dee Dee, and Z. And Z is the cool guitarist, and she's openly bisexual from the very beginning. She's has no problems, like, telling anyone, like, what's going on, you know? She's, like, completely, like on the opposite spectrum of the last character. pretty much, like, open book sexuality-wise, like, will sleep with whoever she's, like, has attracted to. But she's also, like, super confident with herself. She's, like, in a band, and she's a guitarist, and I think that's awesome. You can read the comic at ma3comic.com, and I'll leave that link up. And it is over right now, but I believe you can still read the whole thing from the beginning online, and you should definitely do that if you are of age, because I'm gonna say definitely not the kiddos. And the last character I'm going to be talking about is Billy from the comic Dumbing of Age. There's a lot of main characters in Dumbing of Age. David Willis is the creator, and I've been reading his comics probably since right out of high school, so early 2000s. But Dumbing of Age is his current webcomic that he's been using these characters for some time now. Basically, like, in different universes, like, so characters will be in different, like, relationships than they are in his last comic. So Billy's one of the recurring characters, and she's kind of, like, typical, like, just got out of high school. It's like, I just got into college, and I'm as cool in high school, so I should be cool in college, kind of thing. And then she kind of, like, does grow a lot as a character as the time goes on, as the comic goes on. There's a lot of kind of depressing themes going on with her. She's, like, alcoholism. There's a lot of darker themes in this comic, but it's still a rote, like, comedy. It's still a coming-of-age comedy, slice-of-life comedy at its core. But there's a lot more real-life kind of themes, like, a lot more. Like, if you're able to, like, handle those kind of things, then I definitely suggest reading it, because I love David Willis's comics, all of them. So just be warned that he does give out a warning in his about. If you go on dumbingofage.com, if you look at his about read before posting link, I definitely suggest reading that, because he does, like, give you warnings about all things that might affect you, like, mentally or emotionally. And if you feel like you're not gonna be able to handle that, then maybe don't read it. But if you can, if you're okay with that kind of thing, then I definitely suggest reading it. He does have, like, some adult comics that are on a different website or on Slipshine, but you do have to pay for those, so. But I definitely suggest it. It's very good. His characters are all very strong and very well written, and I love them. They're all great, and there's so many good, like, different, like character development over time with his comics. But I picked Billy because she's kind of, like, not really the most obvious, like, character to go with for this kind of thing, but, you know, she did end up, like, I'm into guys and everything, and then she kind of ended up, like, oh, well, maybe I'm into this girl, too. So I think she might be, like, one of the most relatable characters to talk about. I don't know how you guys have felt over time. Like, I mean, I kind of just felt like, it's like, oh, I'm into guys all the time. And it's like, oh, guess what? No, I'm not. So, I guess, if anything, she's probably, like, the most relatable to me. It's a good comic. Definitely read it. Thank you so much. I hope you guys enjoyed this. So if you guys want to talk about other webcomics you like, or other bisexual characters and other media that you like, feel free to shoot a comment or anything. I love to read other things. I love to, like, watch other movies and TV shows and everything that represents bisexuality. I think it's great. I think comics is definitely one of the best places to find these kind of things, because there's not a whole lot of, like, limits of where we can go with it. We can pretty much just write our own thing and then publish it ourselves and then put it out. So it's like, if we want the characters to be bi, then hey, you know, you might as well. I hope you guys enjoyed my video. Thank you so much for watching. And please leave likes, please comment, please subscribe, All these things, again, are always helpful to me. And I hope you guys enjoyed my video. Thank you again so much for watching. I'll see you all in the next one. Bye, everyone. Thank you, as always, to my patrons, Andrew Linjo, Ben Wright Human, Brandon Tinge, Colin Warmbrot, Council of Geeks, Dark Leap Master, Hexapus Inc., Jack Mahantenny, Jesse Girona, Merrick Bennett, Story Comic, and as always, a very special thank you to my $10 patrons, Corbin Kovalt and Steve Zarzinski.